places like a shopping mall and a college campus. The next trip is to the airport.
We know how it happened. Mm-hmm. How are you doing with the why it happened?
That's been probably the toughest thing for me to deal with, why. And I've sat and thought about all the what ifs. What if I did this differently? What if I did this differently? It wouldn't happen. Why did it happen to me?
Does us no good. We really have to look at moving forward. And from the minute this happened, you know, it's that call that no one expects. And we hear that, it's that cliche, you know, the call we never expect. 2:30 Sunday morning, you just know. And that trip to Columbia was probably the longest drive from Greenville to Columbia I've ever made. But we got there, and she was alive. And that was the most important thing, is that she was alive.
And now it's the serenity prayer that moves her.
God grant me the serenity to accept the things I cannot change.
And there's more change coming for the good. Martha will be home for Christmas. She's scheduled to return to Greenville next Wednesday. Until then, here's a message to her friends back home.
Thank you so much for everything you guys have done for me. I am forever grateful to everyone, and I cannot thank you guys enough. Thank you so much.
She is one courageous young lady, Martha says. She is going to take online classes in the spring, and then she plans to head back to USC in the fall. She says she is not going to let anything stop her from graduating on time.